Of Jesus, I want to welcome everyone once again. Newcomers, welcome. Welcome, first timers, welcome. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi, welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Our ministry is based on spiritual warfare. We deal with the spiritual warfare, and that's why our topic is like that. So you will hear very strong words that we are speaking. We are praying against the enemy. I want to welcome you so much and welcome you. Thank you for coming once again. I'm going to talk to you the subject called Powerful Spiritual Weapon to Destroy Stubborn Problems. Powerful Spiritual Weapon to Destroy Stubborn Problems. Welcome again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. The spiritual weapon is the fire of God. The spiritual weapon is the fire of God. The spiritual weapon that can destroy stubborn enemies is the fire of God. When the fire of God, when you ask the fire of God to visit the camp of the enemies will not, they will not stand. Because that is a fire, it does not care. If to set a fire to the mad person will run. Nobody will stand on the fire. This python, these things that is running on your body, they need the fire. That is stubborn sickness. That does not want to go. They need the fire. They need the fire of God. That is the powerful weapon that God has given to us to use as children of God. If you don't know how to use the fire, I'm going to show you how to use that fire. Witchcraft, they need the fire of God to be burned so that they cannot continue doing what they are doing. Yeah? Every stubborn problem, they need is fire of God. That cancer, that does not want to go, it has killed your family. You need fire to melt it and destroy it in Jesus' name. There was a lady. Our family were dying from breast cancer. Now, with her, she thought that if she cut the breast, then cancer cannot catch her. Then cancer was very clever. It went to attack her from the land. Liver, from the liver. So the cancer went straight and attacked her in her liver. So she cut the breast thinking that she can be free. But she was not free until the cancer went and attacked her liver. So that's why you need to use the fire to melt out that sickness that does not want to go. You need to use fire to melt the powers of poverty that is working against you. You need to use power to stop that stubborn problem going, following you everywhere. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let's look in the book of Hebrews 12, verse 29. Hebrews 12, verse 29. The book of Hebrews 12, verse 29. Hallelujah. Jesus, you are wonderful. Hebrews 12, verse 29. Jesus, you are wonderful. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. The Bible says, for our God is a consuming fire. Our God is a consuming fire. What would God consume? He would consume the works of the devil. He is not interested in consuming papers or a forest. God is not going to consume papers. God is not going to consume papers or a forest or a box. God is going to consume the works of the devil. Sickness, diseases, poverty. That's what God is going to consume. God doesn't have anything to do with the papers or a box. God cannot burn them. God is going to burn the works of the devil. It's not interesting to consume pieces of paper which cannot pose a problem to anyone, which cannot pass the problem to anyone. He simply asks them to disappear and become salt. So The consuming fire of God will consume the works of the devil, the enemies, the stubborn problem that does not want to go. That is the work of the fire of God to consume them. That is a big weapon that we have. That is a very powerful weapon we have, God has given us. That's why we need to use fire very well. People of God, if you know how to use this fire, the devil will not stay with you, because the fire will burn them to ashes. Sometimes you feel things running on your body. Use the fire of God. Use the fire of God and see how that fire will consume them and burn them to ashes. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Another scripture is from the book of Psalms. The book of Psalms 104 verse 4. The book of Psalms 104 verse 4. Jesus, I thank you so much. I am so happy tonight, because I know that this message is going to deliver many of you. It's going to deliver so many people. You have no idea how powerful this message is. And I'm going to show you how to and want to use this weapon, powerful weapon, to stop this stubborn problems. Psalms 104, verse 4. The Bible says, who make it? Is angels, spirits, is ministers, a flame fire. Who make it? Is angels, spirits, is ministers, a flaming fire. God can turn you into a flaming fire, so that when somebody touches you with the intention of doing you harm, the person will have a serious problem, because he will be touching fire. God can make you fire. If enemy, demon, anything will touch you, will touch fire. That's how God will work. It is a very powerful weapon that God can use you. Who make it? Is angels, spirits, is ministers, is ministers. Are you a minister of God? Is ministers a flame fire? God can turn you to fire. You see, when Jesus was praying, and then when they were looking, there was, if you see the book of Revelation, how it described Jesus, you will be surprised. God himself, when he comes with the fire, smoking on fire. So God will make his minister fire. Oh my God, I hope these things has not destroyed that. Yes. God can turn you to fire. If you get to an environment, begin to say, fire of God, come in this environment. And somebody says, no, I don't want you to pray like this. Pray another prayer. Such a person has a problem and should be suspected. So you call fire, fire of God. I call fire. You know, Elijah. Prophet Elijah, he had fire. He was made a means of fire. Elijah was calling fire and consumed thousands and hundreds of people. So Elijah, you could not joke with Elijah, because he was made as fire. Elijah himself was fire. Look at that king. When the king sent about 50 people, Elijah says, if I'm a man of God, let fire come. And the fire come, consume 50. And then another one. If I am a man of God, let fire come, another 50. And then that one, that is 100 people, another 50 came, and then they humbled themselves. They begged Elijah, told Elijah, please, man of God, please favor us. And the people, already 100 people have gone. Please, don't burn us. Yeah? And then Elijah, the angel told Elijah, Elijah, come, go. Yeah? Angel of God told Elijah, go now. Stop that fire, go now and listen and deliver the message. So, a minister, you can be fire. Know that you are a minister of God. You are a child of God. You have that fire. Your work is to use that fire. release the fire to torment the people, to torment the enemies that is tormenting you. You don't need the spiritual attack all the time. You have been attacked by demons. You have been attacked by witchcraft. You have fire to release it. That's why you need to call me. If you don't know your fire, call me. I will pray with you in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that God will help you in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to honor you, Father. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. My God, I bless your name. Hallelujah. Glory be the name of Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I want to tell you that you are a minister. You have fire. Remember the man of God, Elijah, how he was using fire and consuming the enemies. That's why we call God of Elijah, arise, destroy the enemies. Where is Lord God of Elijah? Arise. We have fire already. That fire, we speak the fire will destroy the enemies, will consume them. No one will escape. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Do you know this? Do you know that you yourself, you are fire? God make you flame of fire. Have faith as Jesus says. Jesus said, even if you have little faith as mustard seed, you can move mountain. You can talk to the mountain and obey mountain will pay you. When you have the fire, everything will obey you. You can't talk twice. They have to obey because you release fire. I see people coming for our prayers. And I saw the demons. When I release the fire, the people will scream like crazy. I will show you one of the videos you will be shocked and see. People who come to prayer, they have seen this. Even some, they scare, but now they are used. If you are new, you will be scared. Even you may think somebody is going to die. But the demon, will be, the powers that is working with that person will catch fire and burn and scream and get out of the person. Because if they don't get away, they will burn. So they don't want to burn. They will run. They will run from the person. That's why we are using fire. Yes, my son David. We use fire. And fire, they burn people. And they burn, the people, they will scream. Powers in the life of those people, these people will scream so hard. That's why we are using the fire of God. Now, another one weapon. Powerful spiritual weapon to destroy stubborn problems is another called the arm of God. The arm of God will armor properly, will armor to pieces any stubborn enemy, any powers of enemies. You know witchcraft, they use armor to armor people. Then you feel your head is like it's going to burst. So we have the armor of God. The Bible says in the book of Jeremiah 23, verse 29, the Bible says, is not my word like as fire? As the Lord, says the Lord, and like a hammer that breaks the lock into pieces. The word of God itself is like a hammer. It is a hammer. And it is the fire. The word of God is like fire. The word of God itself is like fire. And the word of God is like armor. It's the armor. Let me show you. Yes. I want to demonstrate tonight. Glory be the name of Jesus. Yes. This is the armor. This is the armor. You know the armor. When you armor something like this, you break it to pieces. We are going to armor the demons. We are going to armor any power, any stubborn problem that does not want to go. This armor is what we are going to hammer them now. Because the word of God is like armor. This is a spiritual armor. I've been praying for this armor. And I know I'm going to break the head of the serpent. The head of the scorpion, the head of the demons that does not want to go. You break them. You use this armor in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, the armor of God. This is the word. That is word. The word, the word. So, if the enemy can use the armor and the hammer people and it works for them, what about us? We have to get spiritual armor and armor the problems. Armor them until they be destroyed in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. I thank God that God has given us weapon. that we need to hammer them, and then they cannot have escape. They cannot escape. Yes, in the mighty name of Jesus, God is has given us weapon. Let us use the weapon God has given us. Stop on problem. They need strong weapon. You can see you work so hard, you've been praying, you've been doing everything, nothing. The stubborn problem is still there waiting for you. They don't hear prayers. You pray, they are looking at you, nothing is happening to you. Yeah. Tonight we are going to hammer them. We are going to burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. I want to pray that God will help you. The word of God itself is so powerful, it's fire. So I'm going to send the fire of God to go to the camp of your enemies and burn them down in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Jesus, I thank you tonight. I pray that I hold the blood of Jesus against every power of darkness working against you, working against your life in the mighty name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus itself is the weapon. Therefore, I am sending the blood of Jesus to destroy anything that is hiding in you, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I'm sending the fire of God. Lord, Father God, Lord, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I am sending the fire of God to start to burn, to assess every stubborn problem in your life, every stubborn problem in your body, every stubborn sickness in your body. Let the fire of God to burn them now. Let the arm of God to hammer it and destroy it in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray, let the fire of God consume every hindrance of your spiritual breakthrough. Every hindrance of your spiritual breakthrough. Let the fire of God to consume them and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of God consume every hindrance of your spiritual breakthrough. Every hindrance. Anything that is hindering you, your marriage, anything that is been hindering you, let the fire of God consume them. Consume them in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I want to thank you, God, because I know the fire will burn them into pieces in Jesus' name. Yes, I'm standing against poverty. Let the fire of God burn down every poverty that is working in your life in Jesus' name. The stubborn problem that has refused to go, I am sending the fire of God to consume them. Let the fire of God burn them to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. God, my God, I pray that God, this witchcraft attack, I am releasing the fire of God tonight, right now, where you are. Wherever you have been attacking this person, every time you attack them, the person cannot be happy. You attack them with dreams, molesting the person. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am releasing the fire of God to fall upon you and burn you to ashes in Jesus' name. Python that is around the waist of the people, that have been, some of them, the python has been rounding their waist. Some of them, they are rounding them up to the neck, they subjugate them. Let the fire of God consume you. You python, you dragon, you serpent, and receive the fire of God and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. I know some of you, some people, when they hear this, they will start feeling heat, and they will feel that creatures come out in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, physically, the snake bit Paul, and what Paul did, he shake it to fire. Because he understood that the fire is the only medicine, it's only the weapon that can kill the snake. So the any snake in your body, any python in your body, programmed by that enemy, let that python burn to ashes. Let the fire, receive the fire of God to burn down anything working against you in Jesus' name. Every attack, the enemy that has seen you, your breakthrough, that you are going to get, and then they are attacking you. Let the fire of God consume them. That is stubborn problem. Yes. 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 That problem. When you are about to get something, you are about to get the job, you are about to get married, the before you get it, the enemy comes and destroy your marriage, destroy, they take away the job. I'm releasing the arm of God the word of God with the hammer and break them in pieces, as the Bible says. Yes, in the mighty name of Jesus, your breakthrough. I am praying divine protection over your breakthrough. You must be get breakthrough. You cannot be having affairs. You want to get married. When you are almost to do your wedding, it is cancelled. The relation is break up. It cannot happen that way. I am releasing the enemy of your breakthrough, a fire of God, fire consuming fire, to go and burn out wherever is behind your breakthrough, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father, your business. You start business. You work so hard. You want to sell nothing. You don't sell at all. You have everything. Your price is good. A neighbor who is very expensive. That's where everybody is going. I am consenting the fire of God to enter into your store and burn down all the jujus, all the germs, all the witchcraft that are put in your stores, to burn them to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty, at workplace, there's a lot of argument. They charge you. They accuse you. They see you like you are an enemy. Yeah, they just want to get rid of you. They make you to be depressed. I am sending fire. Every bad luck, anything that is working against you, I am sending fire of God to consume them in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the arm of God that goes like with the fire burn down and break every strong problem that does not want to go. Every stubborn problem in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, I want to thank you, Father. Let the arrows of fire rocket your oppressors and cut them down and cut them into pieces in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that God Almighty, let the arrows of fire rocket your oppressors and cut them into pieces. When the fire of God will rocket your oppressors, it will cut them into pieces. In the mighty name of Jesus, my God, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I plead the blood of Jesus. I pray, let the arrows with the fire, rocket your oppressors. Those one who are oppressing you. There are some evil people, they like to oppress the children of God. Let the arrows of fire rocket them and cut them to pieces in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Let the stone of fire, that forehead of Goliath, forehead of Goliath, in the mighty name of Jesus, let the stone of fire hit the forehead of your Goliath, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the stone of fire hit the forehead of your Goliath. If there is a problem like Goliath, if there is a big problem, a strong problem, a stubborn problem, that are disgracing you, that are saying, come back again. No medicine can treat me. No doctor can see me. I am here back again. Let that stone of which hate Goliath to hate that problem. You know, there's some problem that is very proud. That nobody can touch me. I am the only one who will kill you. Nobody. Tell me who is that. They mock you. You've been going to the best hospital. Nothing is happening. You spend so much money. Some people, they go to India. They go to everywhere where they see the best doctor. I have seen those people like that. Some, they go to states for better treatment. But the giant Goliath is saying, I am the only one. Nobody. Come. So that sickness, it makes you swallow every money, take everything, then you remain empty. I am sending the stone of fire to go to land in their foreheads and be destroyed and burned to ashes in Jesus' name. That strong problem that does not want, that is rebellious, stubborn problem, I am sending the fire of God to burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. You are a liar. When the stone of David that ran to the head of Goliath, it brought Goliath down. Just a stone. Therefore, that problem that you are facing, that has refused to go, that has become very, very, that has become a big problem in your life. The fire of God will consume them, will consume it, and you will never see it again in Jesus' name. Receive the fire of God. Receive the fire of God. And let it burn every strong, every stubborn problem in your life in Jesus' name. No matter what it is. If it is your children, your husband, wherever it is, the fire will burn them and then the demon will fly away and you will have your children. That problem, that demon, the works of the devil, the works of the enemy, that is operating in the life of your children, operating in the life of your husband. We don't pray against people. We are praying against the spirit, against the powers behind them. Those are the ones I'm sending fire to burn them and destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. There is no point. The Bible says God is a consuming fire if it's not consuming the works of the devil. And he has said that he is a flame of fire, the ministers and the angel spirits. So for sure, God is spirit itself. It can consume you and burn you to ashes. When Daniel was put in the fire, they put him in the fire to die there, to burn there. But the fire did not touch them. The fire didn't touch them. They didn't. There were three Hebrews. The fire did not touch them because God is a fire. Fire cannot touch fire. Yeah? Fire cannot touch fire. You see, you are a minister, you are a fire. So when Daniel and the two boys were sent there, they were fire. So fire could not do them anything. Do you know that you can pass through the fire and nothing? The fire cannot do anything. People can be shocked and say, wow, this is mysterious. Because you are made fire. Look at that story of Daniel. Daniel, they were thrown into fire. The fire did not do them anything. Those people who threw them, they were burned to ashes. They were burned, and those who accused them, they were burned. So you see how powerful fire is this. From today, know that you are a fire. If anybody touch you, it touches fire. So the fire will consume you. The fire will consume them. You have to know that you are a fire yourself. You don't need the enemy to attack you all the time. Demon attacking you. Change your ways and let the fire, let them touch the fire. Here is the Daniel. They did not do anything. They didn't do anything. They were accused that they are worshiping God. And they wanted to kill them. Even he was thrown in the den of lion, whereby the lion were angry for 3 days. They could have eaten Daniel straight away. But because Daniel was fire, so the lion could not attempt. They could have burned to ashes. So the lion said, no, we can't touch you. We can't. We'll stay like that. Even if it's fasting 1 week, we can fast. But we will never touch you because there's no point. If we touch you, we're dead. So why should we touch you? And we see you are fire. So the lion also were afraid for their life. So they never touched Daniel. That's how powerful the fire is. Now, when you have fire, no witchcraft, no powers of darkness will touch you and go free in the mighty name of Jesus. I reject every spirit of fear. Reject the spirit of fear. Command the fire of God to burn the spirit of fear. The spirit of fear which brings a panic attack all the time. You are sitting in one place. You don't want to go anywhere because you fear so much. You fear everything. Let the fire of God consume that demon of fear. That spirit of fear, let the fire of God chase them from your body and let it go in the mighty name of Jesus. You fear everything. You fear everything. So that demon of fear, the power that is in you makes you to fear. Let the fire of God consume them in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. Yes, Lord. Every demonic invisible line that has been thrown around your life, be raised by the blood of Jesus. I pray every demonic restriction placed upon your life, I command them to receive the fire of God and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Every demonic restriction placed upon your life, I command them to receive the fire of God to burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Any power using the night to steal from you, be burned to alive. Be burned to alive in Jesus' name. Let fire, let live fire fall upon the night light. Let live fire fall upon the night lighters. that are coming to steal from you in Jesus' name. Let live fire consume every witchcraft working against you in the name of Jesus. Let live fire consume them. Let them be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every witchcraft that is attacking you, every attacking of the witchcraft from your father's house, from your mother's house, from your household, let live fire consume them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. Power of the night assigned to disgrace you, I command them to be buried now in the name of Jesus. Power of the night. They come, they want to disgrace you. That they come and molested you, they do you awful things. Let the live fire consume them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. I pray the blood of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, my God. Powers of the night troubling your dreams. Traveling your dream life. Some people, they don't sleep. When they go to bed like this, they started war with the dreams. They started seeing things. They get nightmare. They are scared even to sleep. The moment they go to bed, they started seeing things. They get scared. Someone is shooting them. They get so bad dreams. Let life fire consume them. Any power, any night creature, wherever it is, whether animals, wherever the enemy is using to come and disturb you, to come and disgrace you, let life fire consume them. Let God Almighty, let the fire of God consume them in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every power blocking the way of your completely joy, I command them to scatter. Every power blocking the way, blocking your ways of completely enjoy, I command them to scatter. You know, some people, they never enjoy. They have never enjoyed their life. They never even smile because of what they are going through. They have been in pain. They have been miserable. Now they don't know what to do. They are unhappy. They are miserable because of what the enemy is doing to them. Attack, 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 attack all the time. They get scared. Some of them, they can't even eat. Yeah, they have food, but they can't eat. They just look at food with their eyes. They fear, if I eat, this will happen. Let the fire of God consume them and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Yeah, some people, they cannot be happy. They will never be happy. Some of you, since you were married, you have never been happy. You have never been loved. You have never seen any happy in your life. You've been thinking now you are depressed. You wish that whom can I call to talk to me, to say something to me, or who can I talk to? The very person who is your husband or your wife, you are supposed to talk and become friends, but now the enemy has divided you, has put asunder, you don't talk. Some of you, they are waiting the children to reach 18, then they go. That's a lie. Send fire. Where your husband has run away to another woman, or your wife has run away to another husband, send fire. Send fire to that place so that they cannot enjoy. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. The power of the night traveling your habitation, let them die in the name of Jesus. Let them die in the name of Jesus. Every power searching for your face in demonic mirror, your time is up. Let that mirror break on their faces. You know there are some wicked powers, witchcraft. They search your face on the mirror, in the crystal mirror. They look at your mirror. They look and call your name. They search your name. When you appear, they take the knife. They cut you. When they cut you, instantly, you will hear the person is dead at an attack or a crust on the road. Something has happened to that person. And then you will hear that it has done. That's what they are doing. Anybody using the demonic mirror to face your face, let them receive fire. Let that mirror break in their face. That is the prayer they don't want. They don't want to hear that. When you say, let that mirror break on their face, and if it break, that person will go. Their owner who is doing that will die. So they don't want that. That's why fire will consume them. Wherever they call your name in a mirror, when they are calling you, want to appear, let their name to appear, let their face to appear, and let them kill themselves in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Wickedness of the night assigned against your life, I command them to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. There is wickedness, powers of the night, assigned against your life. Let them receive fire. fire and destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, tonight, oh my Father, provoke your fire and angels to fight for these people in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father and my God, tonight, my God, wherever time it is, even this morning, whatever time in your country is, I am asking my Father God to provoke your violent angels to fight for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let angels of God to fight for you. Let angels of God to start fighting for you. Let God release his angels. Call your angels. I am learning angels more about the angels. I will start teaching about the angels soon. You will see the work of your angels. You will call angels of God that God has assigned you to fight for you. Call, even now you can call my angels. Where are you? Arise, come and fight for me. Yes? The angels of God, remember what Psalm 91 says. The angels of God come around you. So they will come around you. And when the enemy comes, the fire, they will meet fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Tonight, witchcraft bird flying against you, I command them to die. Any unusual birds, even now we are going to winter, we are going to, the weather is changing, even where there is no weather, winter, some even Africa country, there is unusual birds can come at night and cry, make noise, or they follow you. Oh, you see, it's normal. It's not normal. Some birds are indeed sent by witchcraft. They use them. In the Bible, we see unclean birds that witchcraft are using them. Therefore, I am commanding them to crush and die in the name of Jesus. By the power and the blood of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. I pray every enemy that came while you were sleeping, I command them to die. The enemy that come to you while you are sleeping, I am speaking to that enemy to die. They will come to attack you while you are sleeping. Let that enemy be disgraced and be destroyed in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The fellow of your father's house, I command them to sink in the Red Sea. Fear of your father's house. Fear of your father's house and the problem that is following you. They don't want to go. They attack your career. They attack your job. If you are a minister and the powers of your father's house, they don't want you to be a minister. They will follow you and attack your ministry so hard so that you cannot have any member or you cannot have people who can help you. That's what they are. They can assign wicked people to be with you, very close to you. These wicked, they are used by your father's, the powers of your father's house, and they will make your life so hard. You work, you pray, fasting, but they cannot let you to go because they are used by these powers and they broke everybody who's coming. Wherever people comes to the church, they are there to destroy. They are assigned, and you see that they get very angry. They want themselves. That's how they are. The powers of your father's house, they program some people, some individual people who can control you, who does not give you chance. Wherever anything you do, they are there and they brought good things coming to you. So I command those the powers of your father's house to sink into the Red Sea in the mighty name of Jesus. I command them to sink and their agents, wherever who has been assigned to block you, to destroy you, who are called unfriendly friends, they pretend they are your friends, they are helping you, but they are great enemies because they have been assigned by the power of your father's house to be agents there to destroy your work. Let them be burned, let them be destroyed. Let them receive fire of God and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, my Father, I breathe the blood of Jesus. I pray, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, I release the fire of God to your prosperity and the prosperity chain, you are chaining your hands. I command them to release you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am sending the fire of God to your prosperity and to burn to ashes wherever is holding your prosperity, wherever is holding them. Let life fire consume them in Jesus' name. And the prosperity chain, I set you fire. I set you fire. I set you fire. I set you fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I have to stop here. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. And remember to call me if you need me to help you to set you fire, to set the to help to command those enemies that is attacking you all the time, call my number. Our number is 877-241-3420. 877-241-3420. And we have a cell phone. If you need to text me, you need to WhatsApp or what we call it. What is that? The other one. Skype. You can reach us by calling this number 647-608-5207. Or another number is 905-487-7196. If those number, all of them, they are not working, then your phone has a problem. Because sometimes it disengages or I'm talking to another person. So you will leave your message. Leave the message. Leave short message. Say who you are, where you are calling from. Leave short message. I will call you back. Somebody will call you back. You don't have to run away that the phone is not, you can't get through. And also some people, their phones, they don't have long distance. So if you don't have long distance, use this number, 877-241-3420. This one is free number. We paid for you. If your phone, if your cell phone, your landline, you don't have long distance, use this number to call me and we can answer you. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time, people of God. See you tomorrow, the same time, midnight. And I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. I also remember God loves you. So if God loves you, I love you too. So I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow. Bye.